Welcome everyone to a new vlog. In today's video I'm gonna show you how to do polenta with mushrooms, fresh thyme, and I'm gonna add my twist to the recipe. It's definitely a comfort food dish and it's specific for Italy, for the mountain area and for some parts of the Switzerland. So we're gonna go now through the ingredients and I'm gonna show you step by step how to do it. Ingredients for this dish, I got here 150 grams of butter. I choose always the butter with the highest level of fat. I got here some lovely scamozza cheese smoked, which we're gonna put on top. It's gonna be delicious. I got some fresh thyme, one shallot, 2 cloves of garlic, black pepper, salt. I got here 60 milliliters of white wine vinegar for the poached egg, you will see in a minute. I got here 60 milliliters of double cream. I got 200 milliliters of milk, Parmesan cheese 100 grams grated, corn flour or polenta flour. I got here 150 grams, 1 egg, and one of the main ingredients. I got some lovely chestnut mushrooms and some oyster mushrooms. Let's prep the ingredients and after we're gonna start to cook. Now all we need to prep for this recipe is the shallot, the two cloves of garlic, and we need to slice the mushroom. So we're gonna start with the shallot. We're gonna finely chop it. And now we're gonna cut the mushrooms. I'm just gonna cut them in half and slice them like this. Chestnut mushrooms, they are much more flavorful than the champignon. Ideally would be to use porcini mushrooms, but I couldn't find any. And to be honest, I don't really like the dry ones. So I prefer to use fresh mushrooms, but different type. Now with the oyster mushrooms, all I do, I'm cutting like this in half, the stalk, the end of it. That's all I do with oyster mushrooms. And that's all my prep. We put them back in the bowl. And we're gonna start to cook. It's a very simple and fast recipe, but extremely satisfying. First I will start with the polenta to show you how I do the polenta recipe. So I got here 500 milliliters of water, which I put earlier to boil. I'm gonna put the heat up. And I'm gonna add the milk in. Now we're gonna leave this to boil. And until this is boiling, I will show you how I do the poached egg. So we're gonna swap them. For the poached egg, I got here the vinegar. It's not necessary to use vinegar. If you don't like it, don't use it. But I like it how it coagulates the egg. So that's the only reason I'm using it. And I'm gonna put just a pinch of salt. Now once the water is boiling, I will show you exactly how to do it. As you can see, the water is boiling, so I'm gonna mix with a spoon to create a vortex, and I'm gonna crack the egg in the middle. and we put the heat down. In 3 minutes the poached egg is perfectly cooked. Now after exactly 3 minutes I'm gonna take out the egg and I'm gonna transfer it straight into a bowl with very very cold water. And I'm gonna just put it on the side. I'm not gonna leave it too much in the cold water because I don't want it to get cold completely. So I'm gonna put it on an absorbent paper to take all the excess water. Now that the poached egg is ready, the water with the milk, it start to boil. So I'm gonna add a little bit more salt. Don't put too much salt because we go with the Parmesan at the end. And I don't want it to be too salty. I got here the corn flour, so I'm gonna add just a tiny bit. I'm gonna mix it in. And we add slowly the corn flour. I'm gonna leave it to start boil again and I'm gonna add the rest of the flour. Now it starts to bubble again, so I'm gonna go in with the rest again slowly. Remember, it's very important, it needs to be a soft, creamy polenta, not a very hard one. So you need to do it a bit runny, don't put too much flour. And now we leave it to boil and mix continuously. Just be very careful to don't end up on your hand or something, because it's gonna leave very deep marks. Now we're gonna put the heat on minimum and we're gonna transfer it on the back fire and we're gonna leave it another 10 minutes to cook. I'm gonna start cook here the mushrooms. I'm gonna show you how I do the mushrooms. Now to start with, I'm gonna put a drop of olive oil. I use the olive oil only so the butter doesn't burn. I'm gonna melt nicely the butter. After the butter is melted, I'm gonna show you step by step what I do. The butter is nicely melted, so now we're gonna put the shallots with the garlic which we chopped earlier. We're gonna put them in. And I'm gonna add only a pinch of salt because the mushrooms, they already got their natural minerals and all that, and you have already the salty flavor. Shake it a little bit. The shallot and the garlic cook very very fast. In 1-2 minutes it's already done. I got the wooden spoon to mix in it. And we put the heat on medium so don't burn the garlic. Be very careful, mix all the times, because if the garlic is burning, it's gonna be bitter. And we need to mix in the polenta as well. Now when the polenta is cooked and it looks like this, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put 2 cubes of butter. I'm just gonna try and to incorporate it in. like that will stay nice and creamy. Put it back on fire. And we mix in this other pan. And now, in the polenta, I'm gonna put the Parmesan cheese. 100 grams of grated Parmesan. We mix it well. And we're gonna put it on the side. If you wanna keep it hot, you can put this pot in another pot with warm water. This looks lovely. Okay, now our shallots and garlic, they are cooked. So we go in with the mushrooms which we sliced earlier. You can put, at this stage, you can put a drop of white wine if you want. All what I'm gonna use is vegetable stock. So now I'm gonna put just a drop of vegetable stock. I'm gonna leave it to until it evaporates all the liquid. And after, I'm gonna add a tiny drop of cream. But first, I almost forgot, we need to put the pressed thyme in. You can do it like this, or you can put the whole stock in and you take it out when it's ready. Anyway, we use it only for flavor. I'll see you in 5 minutes. Now at this stage, I'm gonna put the cream in. I told you, it's only 60 milliliters. And I just added because I want them to be creamy, the mushrooms. You can do it without cream. If you don't like cream or you consider it's too heavy, do it without. I took out the thyme, the fresh thyme. It done his job. It's all the flavors in now. We leave it to boil for another 2 minutes and we're gonna start do the plating. For the plating, I'm gonna use a bowl, a deep plate, a deeper plate. And I'm gonna show you, it's extremely simple what I'm gonna do. We got here the polenta, which is nice and creamy and extremely hot still. So I'm gonna put some polenta in the middle of the plate. Very, very nice and cheesy because of the Parmesan. Now here I got the mushrooms. Where are you gonna put the mushrooms? Over. And now, until the mushrooms are hot, I got the scamozza cheese, the smoked one, so I'm gonna grate some on top. It is still hot. And now we go with the poached egg on top. And some olive oil. I like a little bit of extra olive oil on the plate and on the egg. And because I like it spicy, I'm gonna put a touch of cayenne pepper. And this is my lovely dish. If you don't want it to be vegetarian, you can add 2 slices of pancetta, or you can serve it with sausages. It's totally up to you. I prefer it like this. It's a nice, very hearty vegetarian dish. Definitely a comfort food. Now we're gonna do the test with the poached egg to see how it's cooked. Now let's see what we've done. Is it cooked to perfection or not? I would say it's perfectly cooked. Enjoy it. Thanks for watching this episode. I hope you did enjoy it. If you did, please give us a like, a share. If you didn't, give us a dislike. If you got any questions or any opinions about this recipe, any suggestions, please leave them in the comment section, and I always answer to any comments. Give us a subscribe to the channel. That does help us a lot. And with this being said, I will see you on next Sunday with another comfort food recipe. Phenomenal. Super delicious. Definitely 100% comfort food.